We have seen in this week's introduction that the basic mechanism behind a network scan is engaging the target to answer a probe packet. The type of answer or the lack of an answer can provide valuable information to the scanner. For example, based on the behavior of TCP, the scanner can try to infer if a port is open, in other words, if a service is active on that host, or vice versa, if a port is closed and no service is running. Let's now have a look into some different types of scans. Depending on the type of scan, different information can be gathered. The simplest type of information one might want to gather is which hosts are active. To do this, a scanner will progressively contact all hosts in a target set. It can be a target network or a list of IP addresses, and probe them. There are several ways to do this, in the sense that several protocols can be used for an host scan and give you information about which hosts are alive. A very simple scan in this case is a so-called ping sweep, in which the scanner sends ICMP echo packets to the targets and wait for a request. The advantage is that such a scan is really simple. The disadvantage is that ICMP echo packets can be ignored at the target or can be filtered by a firewall. So such a scan might be unreliable. A different type of information one might want to gather using a scan is which ports are open on a host. This information can be considered a good approximation of which services are active on a host. One can use both TCP or UDP for a port scan. In a nutshell, there are pros and cons for choosing either of these protocols. TCP scan uses TCP responses, like SYN packets or reset packets, for inferring if a port is open or closed. It is considered a quite reliable way of scanning because TCP is connection-oriented, but it might be expensive for the scanner to initiate a TCP connection with multiple destinations. UDP port scanning, on the other hand, is simpler but more unreliable. It needs more guessing for identifying open ports because it will either wait for an error message, for example an ICMP destination unreachable message, or for a legit response for a certain service, DNS for example, if a DNS request was sent. If no message was sent, it will assume that a UDP service is running on the probe port. It has received the probe, but not knowing what to do with it, it has simply thrown it away. Of course, several things could go wrong during this inference process. ICMP might be filtered, and UDP probes or responses might get lost. In the following, we focus on a couple of examples of TCP port scanning. The simplest way of scanning a host using TCP is to rely on the operative system network functions, as to say, use the regular implementation of TCP. A scanner can, for example, use a regular TCP handshake to check if a port is open. It will send a SYN packet, receive a SYNEC answer if the port is open, and then complete the handshake with an ACK. Alternatively, the scanner will receive a reset packet if the port is closed. So far, this is the regular TCP behavior. You might have noticed, however, that the scanner does not actually need to complete the TCP handshake to have all the information it needs. From the scanner perspective, receiving a SYNEC or a reset packet is always needed. If the scanner interrupts the TCP handshake after receiving an answer from the target, we talk of a SYL scan or half-open scan. The scanner will interrupt the handshake with the reset packet. The disadvantage here is that the scanner needs an ad hoc implementation of TCP. A scanner can also try to engage negative answer. For example, in a Christmas tree scan, the scanner sends packet with fin, urgent and patch flag set. The packet will trigger a reset answer if the port is closed, or it will be ignored by the operative system if the port is open. When performing a scan, you can either search for a specific open port in a set of IPs, or vice versa, try to identify all open ports in a single host. In the first case, we talk about an horizontal scan, while in the second about a vertical scan. Vertical and horizontal scan can also be combined in a block scan. Scans are typically the first steps of a more articulated attack, and in practice, a scan and a different type of attack, like password guessing, are often combined. Let's see an example. In this picture, you have a representation over time of an SSH dictionary attack that we have measured at the University of Twente campus. On the x-axis, there is time. On the y-axis, we have a numerical identifier of the IP addresses. A dot indicates that there has been a communication between the attacker and the host. An SSH dictionary attack aims at finding SSH accounts with an easy-to-guess username-password combination. To do this, the first step is to identify hosts with an active SSH service. This is a scan on port 22, which can be clearly seen in this picture as a line. Then, the attack directly progresses to brute force username-password combinations. This is what happened in the second part of the picture.